So the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the Quran. We have to clearly mention to them what is in the Quran. How it is possible to tell these people that what is the Quran until we do not read it? Subhanallah, we read the Quran just for the blessings. Indeed, Quran is the full of blessings. There is no other book on the face of the earth which has blessings as the Quran. But it doesn't mean that we do not understand the Quran. Quran is there to understand, not just for the blessings. Quran is there to understand, not just to keep on the high places in the home. No, Quran is read and understand. To read and understand and to explain to other people. This is the purpose of the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And what the next step would be? وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Avoid these mushriks. Avoid these idol worshippers. Avoid these people who are assaulting and insulting the Quran. Just avoid them. Do not bother, because if you started bothering about them, your life will become hell and you will think that subhanallah, there is nothing in Islam except the accusation from everywhere. As many people think that wherever they go, they do not want to have their national, their identity as a Muslim. Why? Because they are afraid, because of the allegation of the people. Subhanallah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Do not bother about the mushriks, whatever they say. You have to be firm on your aqeedah. You have to be firm on your belief. You have to be firm on your book, the book Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed. And there is no other book on the face of the earth as firm as the Quran. This is the Quran, subhanallah. We must be proud of it. This should be our identity. Every single word of the Quran should be our identity. Not only to recite it, but to understand it, to act accordingly, and to proclaim accordingly, to tell the people accordingly. Subhanallah, dear brothers and sisters, remember this very clearly. The saying of Umar radiallahu ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامًا. That indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the people's rank because of this book, because of the Quran. When you bother about the Quran, when you read the Quran, when you understand the Quran, when you tell to other people about the Quran, Allah will raise your situation. Allah will remove the problems you have in your family, you have in your society, you have as a Muslim ummah. Allah will raise because of the Quran. Otherwise, if we don't bother about the Quran, otherwise what would happen? The same thing as Umar radiallahu ta'ala and said that وَيَذَعُوا بِهِ آخَرِينَ, that Allah destroyed the other nations. Allah put them down and humiliate them because they leave the Quran. So this is very important book. We have to recite. We just finished the month of Ramadan, and alhamdulillah, masajid was full with the reciters who are reciting the Quran, raising their voices with the Quran. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Dear brothers, do not leave the masjid alone. Do not leave the masjid alone. That masjid has to wait for the people who will recite the Quran inside the masjid until the next Ramadan. Do not leave your home as the graveyard, that nobody recite Quran over there, except on few occasions people go and they say, do not make it like this. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the house in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name is not taken, Allah's remembrance is not there, it is like the graveyard. Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all of us in our house from becoming the graveyard. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. And dear brothers, we do not have to be hopeless, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in the next ayah, إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. Whoever is making fun of the Quran, whoever is making the fun of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever is accusing the Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا كَفَيْنَا. We are enough for them. We are sufficient for them to destroy them, to bring them to the account and to put them into the hellfire. Subhanallah, there is no doubt about the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no doubt about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just it is the matter of the time. This is the fact of the time, that one time will come, these people will be among those people who will be the losers, and the Muslims will be the winners, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in many places. And what we have to do, brothers, we have to carry on reading the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr and in the last ayah, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only in Ramadan, not only at the time of Jum'ah, not only when there is a celebration, not only when somebody dies you come to the Salatul Janazah. No, not like this. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Until the death comes to you. until the death comes to you. And this is the only fact on the face of the earth that every human being is going to die. Every human being is going to die. So until your death comes to you, in all the situation, every aspect of your life, we must worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us tawfiq. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Dear brothers and sisters, look after your children. Look after your children. Your children are your khazana. Your children are your treasure. Spend on them, invest in them by teaching them the good manners, by teaching them the Quran, by teaching them the manners of the Quran. Make them grow up worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they will become the wasila for you, for your forgiveness. For your forgiveness on the day of judgment, as our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that on the day of judgment, people will have the mountains and mountains of reward, and the people will look at those mountains and they will be wondering where these mountains from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inform them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, these mountains of reward, this increase in your rank is because of the dua your children have made it. So your children are very important to all of you. Whoever have the children, they must thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They look after them and they should make them grow up according to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. My dear sisters, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to give a special khutbah, a special sermon on the day of Eid. By reminding them many facts, that many times when women speak, all the men as well, when they speak, but so they lies, they backbite other people, they slander other people. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even more few days in a month they do not perform the salat. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to them, he encouraged them to do the sadaqah. He encouraged them to give the charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this charity can wipe out their sins. So dear sister, do not forget that you have to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hold your tongue as you hold in the month of Ramadan. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in many other occasions, that this month of Ramadan is as the training period. As the period came to train all of us, brothers and sisters, children and old people, all of them, they went through with this training period. So the effect of the training should be there and in the other months as well. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Dear brothers, O beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, encourage us to make dua in this occasion on the day of Eid. I would like to remind all of you that whenever you make dua, remember those brothers and sisters who are suffering around the world. The brothers and sisters in Palestine, the brothers and sisters in Kashmir, the brothers and sisters in Pakistan and in many other places who are suffering because of whatever reason. Do not forget them in your duas. They are the brothers in Islam. You have to remember them. And if you make dua to them, and angels will make dua to you as well. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this celebration of ours the celebration full of blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, full of forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna abiduk wa banu abidik wa banu imaik nawasina biyadik madhin fina hukmuk adlun fina qadauk nasaluka Allahumma bikul ismin huwa lak sammayta bihi nafsak aw anzaltahu fi kitabik aw allamtahu ahadan min khalqik an taj'al al-Qur'an al-azim rabiya qulubina. Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'an al-azim rabiya qulubina wa nura sudurina wa jilaa ahzanina wa dhahaba humumina wa ghumumina. Allahumma albisna bihi al-hulal. Allahumma albisna bihi al-hulal واسكننا به الظلل. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك. اللهم اجعلنا له من التالين ولك به من العاملين ولسنة نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم متبعين وعن النيران مزحزحين وفي جناتك منعمين وفي جناتك منعمين وفي جناتك منعمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصرهم. اللهم كن لهم معينا وناصرا. اللهم ارزقهم من حيث لا يحتسبون. اللهم اكس عوراهم. اللهم اكس عوراهم. اللهم اكس عوراهم. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية وماتوا على ذلك. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافه واعف عنهم وأكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم واغسل خطاياهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا فإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم اجعلنا قرة أعين لوالدينا واجعل أولادنا قرة أعين لنا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. جزاكم الله خير. عيدكم مبارك. كل عام وأنتم بخير. تقبل الله منا ومنكم أعمال الصالحات.